Now, quarantine day. Corona may quarantine come. But right now, quarantine no be corona right now for here. It be Defcado TV where we quarantine you. Make you listen and then also try to comment, share, like, and then also subscribe to the channel so that when our next content, you know, you go get on some time for your inbox inside. We go save you straight away for the inbox inside. Yeah, for some days now, we know what the trend, where they go on between rapper Medica and then T-Flo. Yes, but from a quick one from T-Flo in residence in America, is based in America now. He spoke to Sammy Flex on the Showbiz Agenda today, and he makes some serious points, serious intellect. The boy, apart from the rap, you know, the rap, we know, say, you know, but the name, the end, he say, God take Dasham. It made a lot of sense. I know you, some of you go like, some of you too, maybe you don't be fan, so you know, go, you know, they like music or whatever, but then I go lost, say, people go listen. And then you could come up with your judgment right in the comment box as well. So let's enjoy T-Flo versus Medica, and also T-Flo being interviewed by Sammy Flex on the Showbiz Agenda show on Xylophone 102.3. Now, enjoy.
A rich out there, because you are very talented and you put hard work into your craft.
How would you yourself describe the album? One of my panel members, Adam, said, say, this is a combination of songs, or a salad of songs, put in a wine glass, but cocktail of songs. Yes, how would you yourself describe the album as being the owner of the product?
I would say this is by far the best album you can find currently in our generation. Mm-hmm. And everybody should really try to give it an ear, and they would understand the reason why Obimpo saw a salad and a cocktail. Be mad.
A nice one. So you released this as an independent artist. T-Flo is no more on any label?
Yep.
And has it been smooth? Because, yes, you got the opportunity to sign on to a label for some time. So see, now we hear everything as an indie artist now. How is it like? Is it difficult? Is it smooth or a honey hole?
It's smooth and not easy. Mm-hmm. And like we all hear, nothing good comes easy. Mm-hmm. So, actually, they push where you know, say, you know, be easy. Being they tell you, say, when I said, I'm going to go home, I'm going to go home.
Among the streams, which one is leading? Among the songs, we're talking about the digits on the streams, which one is leading?
Currently, my mind day, man, because I was going to go to one point in there. Message, and I think it'd be one vibe, Nkwafo, people resonate with the message more, because even these days, Nkwafo pede, Woyenze maybe, especially Val's Day, so Lebano. You know, my mind day, you know, na order top of the list, and if you honest, you are, it is, I mean, Awalasi, Genesis, and then, I mean, Strongman, Wontasi.
Now I know you are in a different location here in Ghana. There, even if I look at the vibe on Facebook right now, it tells me, sir, Ghanaians, maybe your fans in Ghana, they are going crazy and wild for this album. But where you are now, are you also taking advantage of the situation to win some fans? Have you been introduced to the music world there?
Yeah, and it's been amazing so far. I've had the chance to connect with a lot of very strong, you know, people, and I believe that from this year going, Ghana is going to hear amazing news from our camp. It's going to be crazy stuff, trust me.
Are you likely to sign on to a label where...
I am open to signing to any label regardless of the location, as long as the business and the conversation is right.
But has something come up yet?
At the right time.
I know. Now, Flo, is it also true that at a point you wanted to come to Ghana, but you were not getting money for your ticket? Is it true?
Ticket is something on your problem, man. See, yeah, I mean, I do my, you were, you were, you were, The only thing I'll stop him from coming to Ghana at the time I never paid him back. I was actually supposed to be in Ghana on the 11th. Uh-huh. And
11th of which month? Flying. 11th of which month?
January.
Okay.
You know, and protocols, you know, not that any pay a test now, and you can't test, and unfortunately, you know, it came out positive for COVID, no. And you know, not that any pay a back or quarantine for 2 weeks, and make sure everything is fine. And afterwards, you know, Nyankasa, you had to Ghana, Nyankasa, and every other place, you know, so. When the pandemic is still getting crazy, new strain as in Poliban, you know, not so there. Yeah, you stay the morning, you make sure the safety first.
So how was your recovery process from the COVID? Was it difficult for you to recover? How long did it take for you to recover finally?
It was 2 weeks strong quarantine, and Makadam is in Abba Manyan Kupan because Manko fully feminine. I feel like what I went through was at the very early stage. And Yaminaduma, so my family is here. And if you do an uncle, come on,
Now, for the past about 3 days or maybe maximum 4 days, you have been ruling all the headlines here in Ghana. It started from Twitter and it came here and there. First, once again brought you and the Guru saga, where the Al-Qaeda debate came in. And we were expecting a response from Guru to you, but Guru did not respond to you. Why do you think Guru did not respond to you when you also raised that this is karma hunting you? So what exactly were you telling him when you also came at the time that he was also facing the heat on social media and on Sunday, Al-Qaeda said 2014 was signing Esambay, 2013. Okay, what were you trying to achieve with that?
I wasn't trying to achieve anything. There's one bottom line statement I made, and I would like to actually use this opportunity to tell everybody who is in the industry that whatever you did do, put your heart in it and give it your best. And don't forget that today will change to become tomorrow, and tomorrow can become yesterday. And karma is Bodombia no yesepa intimely be also there yesterday. That be all I go fit talk about this. Yeah.
So you think that what Guru is going through with Kwame Eugene is his experience of karma?
Honest or not?